I am Matt Richards, and I love Jesus. I really love Jesus. And it's a passage. We're in a period of praying and fasting and crying out to God. It's a passage that jumped out at me today. And it's from 2 Kings chapter 20, and it's talking about Hezekiah. It says, about that time, Hezekiah became deadly ill, and the prophet Isaiah, son of Amos, went to visit him. He gave the king this message. This is what the Lord says. Set your affairs in order. If you're going to die, you'll not recover from this illness. Wow. He had bad news. God was saying to him, get your affairs in order. Get your life in order. Get stuff in order. Take care of business because you're going to die. But you know what? Hezekiah responded to the message like this. He says, when he heard this, he turned his face to the wall. He turned away from the word, the bad news, the situation, and he turned it to the wall, and he prayed to the Lord. Stuff happens when we pray. He says, remember, O Lord, I've been faithful to you and your servant, and single-mindedly always doing what pleases you. Then he broke down and wept bitterly. Wow. When we pray, when we cry, when we turn, stuff happens. And you know what? Isaiah, it says, left the courtyard, and he came back as the Lord gave him a message to say that God had heard his cry, and he was going to give him another 15 years. Wow. It goes on to say that God was turning back time and showed Hezekiah that the sign for this would be that he turned the sundial back 10 degrees or stopped the sun. Wow, God will turn back time for those people that pray. But you know, this is the word the Lord gave me today. Hezekiah is a type of the church. Hezekiah means the Lord strengthens. And something that should be strong, something that should be strengthened by God. Let me tell you something, friend. It's dying. It's dying. And we're in a situation where this world is dying. And bad stuff's happening. And I think to myself, my God. You know, we're at the end of the age where the mark of the beast and stuff that's prophesied is happening in our generation. It's crazy. But there is hope. There is hope when we see this bad news. Hezekiah prayed. The church can pray. When the church turns its face away, turns to the wall, cries out, weeps bitterly, then do you know what? God says, actually, I'm going to give you some more time. I'm going to give you some more time. I'm going to redeem the time. I'm going to give you another chance. I'm going to give you some more time for miracles, some more time for the gospel, some more time to see people's life saved. And you know what, friend, there's hope in prayer. And after the church was revived, after Hezekiah was revived, so the nation was delivered from the Assyrians. Wow. We want to see our nation delivered. We want to see our nation go from Brexit and be free and come out of slavery. Let me tell you something. How it happens is when the church gets right, when the church gets revival. And let me tell you, friend, it will get revival through prayer. If my people are called by my name will humble themselves and pray, seek my face, turn from their wicked ways, then I'll hear from heaven and heal the land. It's a call to prayer, friend. Prayer changes things, even the time. God will turn back time for that man or woman that stands in the gap and prays. Please.